going to real quickly go through the other thing that I was wondering about, which had to do with a comment that was made by you after the meeting this last time about how what you were hoping was that the elected board would then contract out with the Glen Rose Medical Foundation to run it. And I don't disagree. Gosh, I mean, I've seen instances, and I think that maybe Meridian is a good example of that, of where sometimes people that are running on the board, if they don't really know how to run a hospital, maybe they shouldn't be doing it. So I don't disagree with that, but you said that you thought that you would like to try to leave it as a private foundation where it wasn't going to be open record. I was a little concerned about that because I feel as a taxpayer that it should be just as transparent as, say, the school board is or the water district or whatever. I asked the Texas Attorney General's office about this, and they said that if this goes through, that the Glen Rose Medical Foundation would no longer be able to be a private foundation and that records should be available through public record things. And that sounds like that was different than what you said. So I just want to clarify, did I misunderstand your comment or...
Well, it was probably stated under different sets of communication, but let me try to address what you said. First of all, once the hospital district board is elected, okay, they will have a decision as to the structure and who will be running the hospital, whether it's the medical foundation today,
sure,
or whether it's community health systems tomorrow or what have you. They will have that total authority. Obviously, I represent Glen Rose Medical Foundation. I would like to see that continue. We've got strategies to take us from where we are today to improve the performance. We have great physicians that have a lot of confidence in this facility. I feel like we've got a strategy that's going to keep those physicians here and keep them supported. Obviously, we would like to see that happen. But to answer your questions about open records or whatever that hospital district board structure is, and wherever they want to go from a legal standpoint, that's what will apply, and that's what will be in place. It won't be what I'm saying today. It won't be what I'm recommending. I'm recommending from a management position, okay, from an organizational position. But the hospital district will have the ultimate authority, and my job will be to make sure that a hospital authority, if I'm involved, will follow the law as it is stated. Open records will be
okay. All right, that's fair.